Blackstone presents Target Switzerland, a Paul Muller novel of political intrigue by William N. Walker. This book is read by Stefan Rudnicki. Target Switzerland is a work of fiction and a product of the author's imagination. While the story endeavors to recapture historical events accurately and to portray real places and institutions, it does so in an entirely fictitious manner, reflecting the author's opinions and conjectures. The novel refers to many historical figures, but they are characterized as the author imagines them. Dialogues and descriptions are fictional and are not intended to depict actual events or to alter the entirely fictional nature of the story. Any resemblance to actual persons or events is entirely coincidental. Dedication. For my wife, Janet Smith Walker, with deep thanks for her love and support. And for my children, Gilbert, Helen, and Joanna, who mean the world to me. The Incident at La Charité-sur-Loire, June 1940. The column of tanks clanked along the dirt road that ran southeast alongside the Loire River. Grassy banks sloped unevenly along the river's edge, and shoals and sandbars sprouted in its path. It conveyed the impression of a placid, lazy waterway, a sense magnified by the soft blue sky and puffy summer clouds overhead. But the Loire was a wide and powerful river, and the current flowed strongly toward the Atlantic Ocean far to the west. It was a formidable barrier, and the orders from division were to find a way across. Lieutenant Karl Albrecht sat easily on the turret frame of his Panzerkampfwagen II tank, his legs dangling into the open turret. Dust was everywhere as the tank tracks ground into the sandy soil. His goggles were useless, scarred and leaky from overuse. Albrecht tied a handkerchief around his nose and mouth, hoping to find relief. He wore no helmet, only his small, visored cap. He'd broken his sunglasses long ago and hadn't been able to replace them, so he kept putting a hand up in the direction of the sun to try and reduce the glare. It didn't help very much. Christ, it was hot. Mid-June and no relief for days from the burning sunshine. The hot, dry breeze sent the dust swirling, seemingly able to find its way into every nook and cranny. He unscrewed his canteen, took a short swig. He could see another of the small villages that dotted the riverbank off in the distance. It would surely have the usual fountain in the center of the village square, where they could halt briefly, splash in the basin to wash off some of the grime and refill their canteens. He didn't anticipate any resistance. They'd seen almost no evidence of the French army since the breakout across the Aisne. What was it? 6 days earlier. Somehow, division had been able to keep sending enough fuel trucks to keep them moving with only minimal delays, and they'd been able to supplement their rations with food and wine seized from the French along the way. Today was June 14th, his mother's birthday. He'd hoped he might be able to find some way to send her a postal card, but there was no chance of that. Even if he'd found a card to put in one of those large brass mailboxes he'd seen in every village they'd passed through, the chances of it finding its way to his home in Wiesbaden were nil. But the thought led him to muse, as he nodded in the heat. How would he ever be able to describe to his mother, to anyone really, even to remember for himself the events that had led him to this somnolent afternoon? It was only 5 weeks since his unit, part of the 2nd Panzer Division of Army Group A, had plunged into the Ardennes forest and begun the long-awaited invasion of France, fighting their way to and finally across the Meuse River. There had been fierce battles at the start, and the French tanks, the Saumois S-35, the Renault R-35, and especially the fearsome Char B-1 with its 47mm turret gun and 75mm howitzer in the hull, were formidable adversaries. But their tactics proved no match for the combined arms striking power of the German forces. Albrecht smiled, recollecting how time and again close radio contact within the division's other units had led them around dug-in and immobile French positions.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.